After the Moon and Mars, the moons of Jupiter are the most promising places to house the future human race, since these places have one of the most critical resources, water. But how could we build human bases on Jupiter's moons? What would these structures be like? And could we stay and live on those bases permanently? Let's find out. Building a human base on a Jupiter moon is a huge challenge. Radiation is one of the main problems for astronauts. Also, Jupiter's moons have an icy and irregular surface. To build a human base on one of Jupiter's moons, we need advanced technology. Problems to solve. Radiation. Radiation on Jupiter is a significant problem for any space mission to the moons of this giant planet. The radiation in Jupiter's environment is due to a combination of factors, including a strong magnetic field and the emission of charged particles from Jupiter's magnetosphere. This magnetic field protects against galactic cosmic radiation, deflecting charged particles towards the planet's poles and generating intense radiation belts around Jupiter. These radiation belts contain highly energetic particles that can harm astronauts and electronic equipment on space missions. A habitat design would be needed to provide sufficient radiation protection. One possible solution would be to use shielding materials and structural design to protect the astronauts. In addition, space suits and emergency shelters could be designed with shielding materials that provide additional radiation protection. Other possible solutions include using energy sources that produce less radiation, such as solar energy, which does not emit charged particles that could damage equipment or endanger the health of astronauts. Furthermore, continued research on advanced materials and technologies could lead to more innovative solutions to the radiation problem in deep space. But perhaps the best way to protect ourselves from radiation would also be the simplest: to build the first human base on Ganymede. Ganymede, Jupiter's largest moon and the only one with a magnetic field, could provide some shielding from Jupiter's radiation. The magnetic field of this natural satellite is much weaker than Earth's, but it can deflect some charged particles from Jupiter's magnetosphere and reduce their impact on Ganymede's surface. It is essential to note that the protection offered by Ganymede's magnetic field would be limited and insufficient to ensure the safety of astronauts or electronic equipment during extended stays on the moon. This location is also exposed to galactic cosmic radiation, which is most intense in deep space, meaning that additional measures would still need to be taken to protect astronauts. While Ganymede's magnetic field would not be enough, at least we would have some protection if we put the first base there. Many scientists believe Ganymede's radiation protection is a good plus for placing the first human base, but others believe the most important thing is water, since there is no life without water. What do you think? Is protecting ourselves from radiation more important, or guaranteeing a water supply? Let us know your opinion in the comments. Water. If we talk about water, the best candidate is undoubtedly Europa. It's known that this moon could have an entire ocean of water below its ice caps. However, reaching it could be quite a challenge, as digging a tunnel from the surface of Europa to the depths of the satellite to extract water would not be possible as easy as on Earth. Consider that the temperatures in these places are shallow, reaching minus 230 degrees Celsius. The frigid temperatures on Jupiter's moons result from their remoteness from the sun and the lack of a dense atmosphere to retain heat. The temperature of a surface depends on the amount of solar energy it receives and the amount of energy it can retain. In the case of Jupiter's moons, most of the solar energy is reflected and the energy retained is deficient due to the lack of a dense atmosphere. An efficient heating and insulation system would be necessary to maintain a habitable temperature in a human base on Jupiter's moons. Heating systems could include electric heaters, fuel combustion systems, or even geothermal power systems if natural heat sources are discovered on any of these moons. Insulation is equally important to minimize heat loss and maintain a habitable temperature. The structures and spacesuits would have to be designed with high-quality insulating materials that minimize heat transfer between the interior and exterior of the base. If we were to extract water from any of Jupiter's moons, it would have to be stored in fully insulated and sealed containers so it wouldn't freeze. We would also have to use sophisticated water reuse systems like those on the International Space Station. In this way, we would not depend on the constant extraction of water. We would only have to extract it once, and that's it. Consequently, it would not be necessary to establish the first human base on Europa. Let's remember that Europa is a smaller satellite than the Moon. Due to this, its gravitational force of attraction is much weaker. If we established a base there, the astronauts would be unable to stay permanently because they would suffer muscle atrophy and loss of calcium in the bones. In contrast, Ganymede is bigger than Mercury. For this satellite, the gravitational force of attraction is more similar to Earth's. If we add the magnetic field to this, they make it the best candidate for a future human base. The most optimal would be establishing a permanent settlement on Ganymede, and the water extracting it from a nearby natural satellite like Europa, and then taking it to the base on Ganymede aboard rockets. Finally, it would be placed in vacuum-sealed containers far from freezing temperatures. Technology. An essential factor to consider is that the technology needed to build bases on some of Jupiter's moons currently exists, one of which is 3D printing. 3D printers are an increasingly popular technology in manufacturing and constructing objects and structures in various fields, from medicine to aerospace engineering. In building a human base on one of Jupiter's moons, 3D printers could be an invaluable tool in reducing the number of supplies that would need to be transported from Earth. 3D printing creates layered objects placed on top of each other from previously created digital designs. The materials used in printing vary but could include plastics, metals, and even bio-based materials. On Jupiter, 3D printers could be used to print structures, tools, and spare parts using the same materials of the natural satellite. The advantages of using 3D printers are numerous. First, the ability to print objects and structures on the spot could significantly reduce the amount of supplies astronauts would have to carry from Earth. This could reduce the cost and complexity of a space mission and make building a base on one of Jupiter's moons more viable. Also, on a natural satellite of Jupiter where the supply of materials is limited and access to spare parts might be difficult, the ability to print objects on the spot could be crucial to the long-term success of the mission. However, challenges are also associated. First, this technology is still in development and has never been tested in a space environment or on a world other than Earth. We don't know how this technology would behave if we put it to work in such a hostile environment. The closest thing we have is the simulation that was made with the construction project of a colony on Mars called Mars Home Planet, led by the technology company Icon and the construction company BIG. In this project, 3D printers were used to create prototype homes with local Martian materials such as regolith, moon dust, tested in a simulated environment on Earth. The idea is that in the future, these 3D printers can be sent to Mars to build large-scale homes and structures using local materials. If they work on Mars, they might as well work on Jupiter's moons. Nuclear energy. In addition to construction with 3D printers, another type of technology that we could use to build the first human bases on Jupiter is nuclear power. This could be the only viable solution to supply energy in a place so cold and far from Earth, since these moons receive very little sunlight, and solar energy would not be enough to meet the energy needs of a base. Nuclear power systems can provide a constant and reliable source of power, which is crucial in extreme environments like Jupiter's moons. In addition, nuclear power systems could also provide heat to keep astronauts warm in the frigid temperatures found in such places. One possible solution for providing nuclear power would be to use nuclear fission reactors that run on uranium or plutonium. These reactors would have to be designed and built to withstand the extreme conditions of Jupiter's moons, including radiation, low gravity, and frigid temperatures. But fortunately, this has already been done. An example of nuclear power in space is radioisotope thermoelectric generators, RTGs. These generators use the heat generated by the decay of radioactive isotopes to generate electricity. RTGs have been used on various space missions, including the rover NASA Curiosity on Mars and the Voyager probes. If we want to build a base on Jupiter's moons, we could implement these types of nuclear generators taken to a larger scale, because instead of powering a small spaceship, they would power an entire base. So we would have to find a way to get such a large generator to a place as far away as Jupiter. Goodbye forever to radiation. As we mentioned earlier, one of the most crucial problems to solve is the amount of radiation the astronauts would receive on any of Jupiter's moons. Radiation is a significant problem that must be addressed during the construction of the base, so it will be necessary to implement radiation-resistant materials in the structures that serve as shields to protect all astronauts. Research into advanced materials such as carbon nanotubes could be crucial to building a human base. Another viable option would be to build artificial magnetic fields. Building huge copper coils could produce these on the principle of electromagnetic induction. Electricity would generate a magnetic field large enough to shield the space base from radiation from Jupiter. Finally, we must remember that all this is based on the science and technology that we have for now. An enterprise as challenging to achieve as colonizing the moons of Jupiter is something that will take several decades or perhaps centuries. Building a human base on one of Jupiter's moons represents humanity's exciting challenge. We are on the threshold of a new era of space exploration, in which we can extend our presence beyond Earth and begin to colonize other worlds in our solar system. Although many technical and scientific challenges exist, we have the technology and knowledge to realize this vision. But beyond the scientific and technological benefits, the construction of human bases on Jupiter's moons represents an opportunity for humanity to have an object in common and explore the unknown together.